Hello, I'm Philip Duncan. Thank you for joining us for our Tuesday weather update recorded on February the 27th. And we've got low pressure parked over the country at the moment. It's got three main centres, one out to the west, one out to the east, and the other one out here over the Chatham Islands. Subtropical airflow coming down, or at least it's a nor'wester, so that's why it's still pretty warm and humid. And that humidity curves around as an easterly for many places, might even be a southeasterly, but it's coming out of the subtropics. So a normal cold direction, but warmer airflow is coming through. And we'll be seeing a few heavy showers forming as a result of that. Bit of low pressure in the tropics, nothing to worry about. In fact, low pressure is disappearing from the tropics over the next week ahead. Our Pacific Islands update is out today, so take a look at that. And over in Australia, low pressure here around South Australia, driving in a few thunderstorms and a cooler change for Western Australia. But this high drifting out from the east, that is the next feature moving in towards New Zealand. So let's have a look at it now on the animated cloud map. You can see for the next 48 hours, that high drifts right in and over the South Island and to some degree parks over central parts of New Zealand by Thursday evening. Mostly dry. This pushes away a lot of cloud, maybe a few lingering showers in Hawke's Bay, but most places are drying out as that high starts to roll on in. So let's have a look at the rainfall. This is for the next 48 hours from this evening, and most of that heavy rain lines up along the eastern side. In fact, I shouldn't call it heavy rain. It's just drizzly stuff with a few isolated downpours. So not everyone will get a heavy downpour of rain, but the chances in there across eastern areas, especially inland parts of Canterbury, and maybe up here in northern Hawke's Bay. But the rainfall totals aren't much. I mean, this area here might get 30 or 40, but most other places are down in that 5 to 10 millimeter mark. Now, one more thing before we get into the forecast. Yesterday in Auckland, 19 degrees at the warmest part of the day. And look at the red line. Oh, sorry, that's humidity. But look at the purple line here. That is the air temperature. Basically, completely flatlined. So it was 19 degrees on Monday afternoon. And then by Tuesday morning at 5 in the morning, it was 20 degrees. It was actually a degree warmer. Very unusual for that to happen in Auckland. It was due to the cloud cover, very thick cloud cover, blocking out a lot of the sun's heat yesterday. And warm, cloudy weather remaining overnight. Wellington's one other place that gets that. Wellington sometimes flatlines with temperatures, mostly because the wind through Cook Strait can drop your temperatures by day, but then nighttime helps keep that temperature up. So a little strange twist in the north of the country. Let's get into the forecast. So here we are on Wednesday lunchtime. There is that high we just talked about. You can see the low south of Australia, not very much of one, just moving along there, keeping things pretty dry and very hot with that nor'wester coming out of Aussie, which then comes around into New Zealand as a easterly. We've also got this low dragging down subtropical air. So it's an unusual mix. A lot of places will be quite mild on Wednesday, despite the fact that locally you might actually have a southeasterly wind. Now by Thursday, slightly cooler morning for some of you, high pressure balloons out across the country, just a few showers lingering here in the east and maybe also around eastern parts of Northland, otherwise dry. Coming out of Australia, a westerly change, but see the red line here, hot tropical air being pushed out into that nor'wester, which means New Zealand's about to warm up. So we kind of feel like autumn's here at the moment for some places, but as we move through this week, hotter weather moves on through. So that pulse of warm air comes into this part here of New Zealand. So Friday, end of the week, pretty warm for southern parts of the country and mostly dry nationwide. As we go into Saturday, that hotter airflow out of Australia moves into the North Island and the top of the South. There'll be places into the upper 20s and early 30s. We're expecting Marlborough to be into the 30 degree mark this weekend. Not what you want. Most of you want some wet weather, or at least did a week or two ago. We've got some rain on the west coast coming through. Now, this is the cold front we talked about yesterday. Some big stormy stuff down here. This high, south of Australia, stops that storm from blowing up and going everywhere. But as it moves towards New Zealand, we get the precursor cold front. So Sunday could still be quite a hot day for those in the east. But as the day wears on, the front comes in, the temperatures drop, and it's a slightly cooler Sunday evening or Monday morning, depending on where you are. But now all eyes are on this system. So we get to Monday, and the center of the low, yesterday it was right up here. Today it's being dragged all the way down. It's this big, long, stretched out low. So that's worth monitoring because it may end up going further away from us. But for now, the placement of that low and the next high encourages a very windy change. Now, it could be quite hot on Monday with that nor'wester blowing up to severe gale, but behind it, more wintry. Could be snow on the mountains. heavy west coast rain, strong winds, could be a number of wind warnings and rain warnings, thunderstorm warnings, the whole lot being thrown at us next week from Met Service. So we'll be keeping a very close eye on that for Monday. That is all from me for today, though. We will see you again tomorrow, Wednesday, with our next update.